When Jim Hines won his gold medal in the 1968 Mexico City Olympics, he established a mark for the 100-meter dash that has yet to be bettered in Olympic competition. He added a second gold medal that year as a member of the 4x100-meter relay, and Jim joins us this morning in our studio. Thank you so much. You are sitting here knowing that your record is held for 16 years. Do you think it's about to be broken tonight?
Well, it was a possible chance. When I set the record in 1968 in Mexico City, I had just broken Bob Hayes' record previously, which was 10 flat in the 100-meter dash. And if Carl Lewis runs a dream race, he would have to do this to break the record. He'll have to get a good start, run a strong middle, and he'll have to have a strong finish to do this. And if he does these three things, he'll have an awful good chance to breaking the record.
You still hold the Olympic record of 9.95, and up till a year ago, you held the world record of was broken by Calvin Smith in 9.93. Calvin Smith won that at the Sports Festival, and he doesn't make the team this year for the Olympics. Does that surprise you?
It surprised me very much, because a person that runs 9.93 to break my record of 9.95 after the hell for 15 years, and then he doesn't make the team, he takes fourth. I mean, I'm sure Calvin has to be feeling real bad now to be sitting on the sidelines watching Carl go for the goal, when maybe he would have had a possible chance of beating Carl if he had went on and ran the way he should have ran, maybe when he ran at 9.93.
Do you feel like the fastest man on earth?
Well, my record speaks for itself. I feel I am the fastest man since God created man, because I set the record back in 1968. It's been a very durable record. There have been thousands of attempts made at it throughout the 16 years. And this is the 1984 Olympics, and they'll be trying to break it coming up tonight. And yes, I would have to be called officially the world's fastest human, you know, until somebody breaks the 9.95 in the Olympics, because the Olympics are the only place where a record is officially recognized throughout the whole world when all the countries are competing.
Jim, do you wish you were competing here in L.A., especially the fact that now these, you know, Carl Lewis, his competitors have such great technology on their side, faster shoes that are... that some companies have spent hundreds of thousands of dollars developing?
Well, yes. Sometimes I think that I wish I could be running today, because in the 60s, 1967, 68, when I was running my times, those 9.95s and 9.6s and 9.7s, they said I was 10 years ahead of my time. So if I had been running today, maybe the record would be 9.75, you know, with the technology, the shoes, and if I was young and being able to run today.
But your Olympic hopes still aren't over, because you have two kids that you think both can run a 100-meter dash and hopefully will make 88, correct?
Well, that's correct. I have my son who's 17 years old, Jimmy Hines Jr., and I have my daughter who's 12 years old, Kimberly Hines. And Kimberly, she's run 13.1 for the 100-meter dash, which is really fantastic for a 12-year-old. And Jimmy, he's running around 10.7 or 10.89 in the 100-meter dash, and he's also run 48 in the 400-meter dash. And also, I'd like to say about my two kids, they are straight-A students. I'm very proud to say that for the last 5 years, they have been straight-A students, and my son, Jimmy, he can go to college, not on an athletic scholarship, but on an academic scholarship, so I'm very proud of that, to say that.
Jim, thank you so much for being with us, and coming on later on this morning is going to be Bob Hayes, who's live from Texas, and when we come back, we're going to have more boxing action from the sports arena in Los Angeles, all coming up as the 23rd Olympiad.